dry bones hear the word of the Lord. Amen. Yung dry bones na to na sinasabi sa Ezekiel, it implies the kind of life or the kind of life that we have, no? Actually, pag sinabi mong dry bones, ay wala na, lifeless talaga yan. No hope to live, dry na nga eh, 5 years or more. Talagang ano na yan, dead na yan pag sinabi mong dry bones. But with the Lord, nothing is impossible. Amen? Our life seems to be like dry bones. But when the Lord and the man of God prophesied to these bones, when they hear the message of the Lord, they live. Amen? That's why it's very important that we hear the word of the Lord. Amen? And the word of the Lord is life. Kaya nga, this 2021 is very important that in the beginning that we started with the word of the Lord. Amen? No? And I would like to share with you, we will continue the series in the beginning. In the beginning, God created. It all start from the Lord. In the beginning, God is there. And in John chapter 1, verse 1, in the beginning was the Word, and the Word was God, and the Word is God. Amen. So, today, I would like to share with you the message about worship. No, it is entitled worship. No, from the root word worth. No, karapat dapat. No, deserving. And pag ang isang tao, isang Kristiyano, tinanong mo po, saan ka pupunta? Sunday? Doon, sisimba. Ano kaya sasamba? Yan. Or ano kaya sa tinanong, nagkita kayo, galing na siya sa simbahan. O saan ka pumunta? Nagsimba. O sumamba. No? But many of us confine worship just only during Sunday. Kino-confine natin ang pagsamba sa Diyos. No? Parang nasasabi na natin na ako, sumamba ako. Sumamba ako, nag-worship ako kay Lord kasi pumunta ako ng Sunday. But worship is not confined just during Sunday. Hello? And worship is more than singing song and going to church. Worship must be our lifestyle, and worship is our life. Amen. Because our lives must be dedicated to God daily, in a daily basis, not only during Sunday. So we need to have that confound understanding about worship. Si Napoleon Bonaparte, sabi niya po, if Socrates enter into the room, we would all rise and do him honor. Kung kilala niyo si Socrates, no? Pag dumating siya sa isang sa room, lahat ay tatayo at magbibigay ng galang. At sabihin natin, pag ating Presidente Duterte dumating dito sa room na to, everyone will rise up and give him honor, of course. He deserves it. But Napoleon said, if Jesus Christ come into the room, everyone would all fall down and worship him. Amen? Now the reason we worship, we raise our hands, get into our knees and adore Him is because Jesus Christ is God.
Amen.
Amen. No? Sinasamba natin ang ating Panginoong Jesus dahil sa ay Diyos. And He deserves it. Kaya nga, worship. Worship comes from the word worth. Siya ang karapat-dapat na sambahin. Wala nang iba. Walang pwedeng sambahin sa mundong ibabaw na to. Hindi pwede ang puno, ang ibon, ang anumang, ang drum set, or anybody. You cannot worship anyone, any human being. We can only worship only God. Only God deserves our worship. Sabi po sa Philippians chapter 2, verse 10, that at the name of Jesus, Jesus. Say Jesus. In the name of Jesus, every knee should bow. Hari ka dito sa mundo, queen ka, presidente ka, mayaman ka, mahirap ka, babae, lalaki, bata, matanda. Every knee should bow. In heaven and in earth, those under earth, kahit sa ilalim pa ng dagat, every knee will bow in the name of Jesus. And every tongue shall confess that Jesus is Lord, the glory of the Father. Amen. Sabi dyan, every tongue shall confess that Jesus is Lord. In the original meaning po ng Lord, automatic po ang Lord ay King. That's why when Jesus came, He preached about the kingdom of God. Kaya nga, ini-expect, nung nag-prophesy that Messiah will come, they are expecting King to come. Gaya nagtaka sila, kung yan ang hari, bakit sa sabsaban, dapat sa palasyo? But the wise men came to him, no? And bow and worship Jesus in the manger because they recognize that Jesus is the promised King. He is the King. Amen. That's why He is the King. That's why He is the Lord. Ang King, automatic Lord. Amen. And there are reasons why we worship Him. Number one, for who He is. For who He is. Amen. Let's pray first. Father God, Lord Jesus, Holy Spirit, we honor You, we glorify Your name in this congregation. As we gather together, Lord, that we want to glorify Your name and continue to dedicate our lives to You. Lord, let Your word continue to be heard by the dry bones, by Your people, Lord, that we may have that understanding of who You are and about worship, Lord, why we need to worship, O God. Open our spiritual understanding, Lord. Liberate our mind. Thank You, Father, in Jesus' name. Amen. Amen. We worship Him for who He is. Sinasamba natin ang Diyos, ang Panginoong Jesus, kung sino siya. Because He is God, according to the scripture. Jesus is God. Amen. Unlike si Thanos, kilala niyo si Thanos, na if you watch the Infinity War, the Avenger, no? He was trying to become like God. That's why he's trying to kill everybody. He wanted to be God. But our God did not become God. Because our God was God, is God, and forever will be God. Amen. He did not become God by crushing anyone, by crushing everything that comes in His way. From the very beginning, He is God. Amen. That's why He is worthy of our worship. He was, He is, and forever will be. And He gave His Son, being God, so that all of us will be rescued. That is why He is worthy of our worship. Amen. Sabi po sa Philippians chapter 2 verse 6, though He was God, see, the description of the scripture about Jesus, He is God. Though He was God, He did not think of equality with God as something to cling on. Jesus was God, the Alpha and the Omega. Amen, the beginning and the end. Kahit siya ay Diyos, pinili niyang hubarin ang kanyang pagka-Diyos upang tayong lahat ay maligtas, siya ay nagkatawang tao. So therefore, no question at all, Jesus is God. He is the Son of God. That's why He is worthy of our worship. Amen. And secondly, we worship Him for who He is to us. Because who He is to us. Sino siya sa atin? We remember where we came from. Sinasamba natin, ina-adore natin, hinahangaan natin, no? Nire-respeto natin, pinapupugayan natin ang ating Diyos kung sino siya at kung ano ang ginawa niya sa atin. Meron pong story, isang prisoner. Prisoners, actually marami sila, prisoners who were released through a negotiation by the president somewhere in 1900s. Na nakulong po sila sa ibang bansa. And through negotiation by the president of US, they were able to go back from imprisonment, they were able to go back from to the land of United States. You know, these prisoners, the very first thing they did was they kneeled down and kissed the ground. They kissed the ground. But you know, if you, an average person, if you are an average person na was walking in America, imagine natin tayo mga ano, Amerikano, living in the United States of America, an average American, they won't kiss the ground because they take for granted, no? They take for granted yung land. Pero kung ikaw, nakakulong ka, prisoner ka, at pinalaya ka at babalik ka sa iyong lupang tinubuan, coming from the prison, as you arrive in your own country, you will gonna kiss the ground. Lalo po ang ating presidente, when he kissed the ground of Davao. Marami taking for granted na yung pagiging Kristiyano, taking for granted when it comes to worship. But you know, the reason why we get on our knees before God is because we remember who we were used to be. Amen. Naalala natin kung sino tayo. We were prisoners before. Prisoners of sickness. Prisoners of the devil. Prisoners of curse. Prisoners of death. Amen. No? At marami pa na ang buhay natin ay nakakulong sa maraming bisyo, sa maraming kasalanan. And we cancel that. We cancel yung mga pinagdaanan na natin yan at naalala natin kung sino ang Diyos sa atin at kung paano niya tayo pinalaya. Amen. Kung aalalahanin natin palagi, no? Kung ano ang ginawa ng Diyos sa buhay natin, kung paano tayo niyang pinalaya, pinagaling, pinatawad, no? No moment during worship, no, that we will not kneel down before Him. Amen. We will not be casual in worship, whether in the church or at home, because we remember who we were. Amen. No? That's why during worship, we worship not just by style. We worship not for the preference of our songs. Oy, gustong-gusto ko yung kanta niya. Abisado ka yan. Ramdam ko yung kanta niya. Kaya makakapag-worship ako. It's not, that's not worship. Or, worship is not about the music. It is not the loudness or quietness of music. Worship is because of the God who is the only object of our worship. Amen. Kaya whether alam mo ang kanta o hindi, whether type mo ang music mabilis, mabagal, malakas, mahina, you don't care. Because worship is not about music. It's not just about the song. Worship is about God. Amen. Hallelujah. Sige, let us clap our hands for the Lord. He deserves our worship. Amen. Bringing back the praise to Him. May isang babae sa Kansas City, narinig kong itong kwento na to. Nakapila po siya, bibili siya ng ice cream. At nung nakapila po siya, nakita niya po si Paul Newman, kung kilala niya si Paul Newman, a director Hollywood, no? A director in Hollywood, nandun sa likod niya, siya nandun na sa unahan. at bibili siya ng ice cream. At nung nakita niya, na-overwhelm siya, no? Tapos, kinamayan niya. Tapos habang kinakamayan niya, sobrang na-excite siya. Ninenervous siya kasi si Paul Newman to eh. Magaling na direktor. At inanano na siya, binati din siya. Binati niya rin. And pagkatapos noon, umalis na siya. She walked away. She took her ice cream and walked away. At habang naglalakad na siya papalayo, na-notice niya, sabi niya, asan yung ice cream ko? Asan yung ice cream ko? So bumalik siya doon sa ice cream shop. Tapos, sabi ng guru sa kanya, nakalimutan mo yung ice cream mo. Sabi niya, oo, nakalimutan ko. Sabi niya, nilagay mo sa purse mo. Nilagay mo sa bag mo. Sa sobrang excitement, sa sobrang overwhelm, na na-meet niya ang isa sa pinakamagaling na direktor ng Hollywood, he forgot na kung saan niya nilagay yung ice cream. She lost herself. When was the last time that we lost ourselves in the presence of our God? When was the last time that God affected your pulse? When we saw our crushes, when we saw our favorite movie actors, nakita natin si Daniel Padilla, no? Nakita natin favorite natin basketball player. Nakita natin ang favorite celebrities natin, na-overwhelm tayo at minsan nawawala tayo sa sarili natin. Minsan yung sobrang fitness mo. Pero pag nakita mo yung favorite celebrity mo, nawawala ka na, nawiwindang ka na. You're so overly excited. When was the last time His presence makes you shake? When was the last time that when you come to His presence in the church, that you lost yourself? Worship team, when was the last time? Kaya nga po yung mga worship din natin, I'm telling them, do not be so casual when you worship. Because whether you are a worship team, did you belong to the worship team or not, you are a worshiper. Alam mo, meron na kwento dyan eh sa Bible na nawala siya sa sarili niya. Hindi naman yung parang mabaliw. Pero pwede namang mabaliw para kayo. The woman caught in adultery. She was forgiven. She was forgiven. The people wants to stone her. And because she was forgiven, that Jesus told him, I will not condemn you. Rise up and sin no more. And after that encounter, that woman became his follower, Jesus' follower. At nung bumalik siya, dala niya ang pabango. Yung pabango na yun ay 1 year. Worth 1 year wage. Let's say sa isang ano, kung malaki ang ano taga, almost 1 million or 500,000. Binasag niya sa harapan ni Jesus para lang iguho sa ulo, hanggang paanan at sa talampakan. At pinunasan niya ng kanyang buhok. She lost herself in the presence of His Savior and Lord. When was the last time that we lost ourselves? When was the last time that you lost yourself, that you wanted to give all to God? Yes. Kaya nga itong ating giving sa pledges, even in our commitment in service to God in the ministry. No? Enough reason is God has forgiven us. He loves us and He has forgiven us. Amen. When was the last time you feel nervous because He came into the room? That you sense His presence. Sometimes you are so casual, you just stand. And no feeling at all, no demonstration, as Guru sinasabi natin. Hindi kasi ako expressive. But you know, pag nakasalubong mo si President Duterte or si Daniel Padilla, yung people, hindi ba magkakaroon pa ng expression? Hello, much more with our Lord and Savior. Amen. You know, in the Old Testament, when people meet God, they fall on their face. They fall on their face. And even the mountains, the very mountains, were shaken because of His presence. kahit ang mga bundok nanginginig sa presensya ng Diyos. And in the New Testament, when people meet God, in the New Testament, they were changed. May transformation, may pagbabagong nangyayari sa isang tao when they encounter Jesus. It's impossible that you encounter Jesus here in this room, in your devotion, in your Bible reading, and you remain unchanged. When you really encounter the presence of God, you will change. Amen. Like Peter, he encountered Jesus and he was changed. Like Paul, murderer and becoming a missionary. Woman caught in adultery. Nicodemus. It is impossible to be hit by a trap and remain the same. Pag ikaw, nabanggaat na sagasaan ka ng trap, pisat ka, duguan ka, broken ka, hindi ka pwedeng, hindi ka mabalian. It is impossible to meet God and remain unchanged. We cannot afford to be casual before the Lord as we encounter His presence. Amen. Katulad ni Haring David, when they transferred the Ark of the Covenant, Ark of the Covenant is the symbol of God's presence. Dinala nila ang Ark of the Covenant going to Jerusalem. And when the Ark of the Covenant, the symbol of His presence, already transferred in Jerusalem, as a king, he was a king, Haring David, hari siya. Pero nung nandun siya at nakita niya na ang Ark of the Covenant na bumalik na, no, sa city of Jerusalem, hinubad niya ang kanyang robe. Naghubad. Nagsasayaw, naglulundag, tumangling. Nagpuri sa presensya ng Diyos. Kaya nga nung nasilip siya ng kanyang asawa, sabi niya, grabe, hari ka. Pero you look undignified. Ano sabi ni Paul? Ano sabi ni David? Mas gusto ko namang nang maging undignified before the presence of God than pleasing anyone. Amen. Are you willing and are you ready to look undignified before His presence? Yung pagmalakpak, yung pagtalon, yung pagsigaw. Maybe it looks undignified. Kasi hindi ka sanay eh. Tama? No? Kilala ka ng mga tao, astig ka eh. Kung meron mong aastig si David Jun, warrior, mandirigma, pero sa harapan ng Diyos, look undignified. He worshiped God. Because he know God. Amen. Know God that He is God and He knew where He came from. From being a shepherd boy to a king in the palace. Sabi po sa Isaiah chapter 43 verse 7, bring everyone who is called by my name, whom I created for my glory, whom I formed and made. Take note of this, whom I created for my glory. God formed us for His glory. He created us for His glory. He created us for worship. Your life is for His glory. Yes, we are called to warfare. We are in war zone. Man is called to take dominion. Yun ang calling natin to do. We are called to do our assignment. To wage war against demons, sicknesses, poverty, and curses. But you know, our calling and what we are created to be, sabihin nyo nga to be. What we are created to be is become a worshiper. Amen. To become a worshiper. Hallelujah. We are created to do an assignment that is to wage war. However, We are created to be a worshiper, created for His glory. God has the rightful worship as you have for your car keys or your cell phones. Alam niyo ba that God has the rightful worship? Karapat dapat. Kanya yan. Ang worship sa Kanya yan. It belongs to Him. Amen. Parang ano lang yan, susi ng kotse, susi ng motor, or cellphone. No? Kapag nawala ang susi ng kotse, o nawala ang cellphone, mahahanapin mo. Bakit? Kasi sa'yo yan. Amen. That's why when He said to Malachi chapter 1:6, this is what the Lord Almighty says, a son honors his father, a servant honors his master. So, if I am a father, where is my honor? Kung siya ang iyong ama, nasaan ang respeto at paggalang natin sa Diyos? Hinahanap niya. If I am a master, if He is your Lord, where is your respect for Him? Where is my respect? The Lord says, your priests despise my name, but you ask, how have we despised your name? We worship Him, number three, because worship belongs to God. It belongs to God. Worship is owned by God. Katulad ng cellphone na kapag nawala, hahanapin mo. Kasi sa'yo yan. Amen? It is rightfully His. Honor belongs to God. Huh? God says, where is my honor? It is mine who took it. Hindi natin pwedeng kunin ang honor and glory. It only belongs to God. We cannot accept any kind of worship because worship belongs to the Lord. God sees praise and worship as rightfully His, like anything that we own and rightfully belong to us. Ang bahay, may title yan, sa pangalan mo, sa'yo yan. Hindi pwedeng angkinin ng kahit sino. Ang kotse, meron niyang ORCR, nasa pangalan mo, sa'yo yan. Hindi pwedeng angkinin niya ng kahit sino. Same with the praise and worship. It belongs to God. Amen. 1 Chronicles chapter 29, verse 11. Greatness, power, splendor, glory, and majesty are His, are yours, Lord, because everything in heaven and in earth is yours. The kingdom is yours, Lord, and you are honored as head of all things. He's not just king, He's not just the Lord, but He is the creator. And everything that we see, including your life, belongs to Him. And He said, you are created for His honor. Sino dito yung gagawa ka ng isang object o ng bagay para i-dishonor ka? Wala. Kahit ang mga anak mo, gusto mo magkaanak. No? Pero ang gusto mo, i-honor ka as a father. Amen. The reason God created us is for His honor. That we give Him the worship that belongs to Him. Ang tanong is our lives giving glory, giving honor to His name. Kaya kung meron ng perfectly that worship God, perfectly gives glory and pleasure to the name of our God, it is the Son, Jesus Christ. Amen. That's why worship is not just singing songs, playing instrument, but it is life that gives honor to His name. In Revelation chapter 4, verse 11, our Lord and God, you deserve to receive glory. Amen. Honor and power, because you created everything. Everything came into existence and was created because of your will. People of God, human beings, huwag natin kalimutan kung sino ang lumikha sa atin. And never act as if we are not created by God. Let us not live dishonoring Him. Kaya nga, no? Many times that nagdidinidil yung mga unnecessary sa buhay natin. Why? Because our life, clearly the Bible said, it should be an honoring life. Pag nagmumura ka ba, nag-glorify si Lord? Yun na ang tanong kaya, whether you eat or drink, do it for the glory of God. Pag umiinom ka ba, nag-glorify si Lord? Pag naglalasing ka, nawawala ka na sa sarili mo. Pag nag-a-addict ka, di ba? Sobrang high ka na sa drugs. Nawawala na ang dignity mo. No? Nagsusukat ka na sa kalye. Kapag ka ba nagkakaroon ka ng illicit relationship, fornicating, nape-please ba si Lord? That's the reason. No? That's the question that we should answer every time na may gagawin tayo. Does it honoring God? Amen. And Psalm 115 verse 1, not to us. Sabihin mo sa sarili mo, not to me. Not to us, O Lord. Not to us, but only to your name goes all the glory for your unfailing love and faithfulness. Not to any human being. Kahit sa sino mang pinakamataas na hari pa dito sa mundo at pinakamakapangyarihang tao, they never deserve this glory that belongs to God. For your unfailing love, the scripture says, and faithfulness. In Isaiah 42 verse 8, I am the Lord, that is my name. When you say Lord, He is the one in control. He is the master. Pag sinabi mong Lord, Master, siya ang dapat nasusunod. Amen. Yung buhay natin, sinong nasusunod? Madalas po, tayong mga tao, we have will. Pero you know, we have that power, that will to be submitted under the will of our Lord and Master. Kaya nga, when we become born again, we confess Jesus as Lord and Savior. Kaya nga, hindi lang Savior, kundi Lord. Pag sinabi mong Lord, pag Master, yung gusto niya na, ang masusunod, not my will, but yours be done. Nag-set ng example si Jesus when He confessed that not my will, but yours be done. When He was about to be crucified on the cross, gusto man niya na hindi dumaan sa cross because He know that terrible suffering that He will going to experience. But He said, Lord, Father, not my will, but yours be done. Lord, gusto ko siya. Itong gusto kong gawin. Dito ko gustong pumunta. No, pero pag sinabi ng Lord, no, or listen, wait. Lord, I want it now. I want Him. I want that. I want to do it. We are the master and the Lord of ourselves. No? Kaya nga si Mary Magdalene, as si Mary, no, the mother of Jesus, when she was in, she encountered the angel, sinabi, magbubuntis ka by the virgin birth. Sabi niya, paano yun? Wala na ng asawa. Magpapaksal pa naman kay Joseph. Iskandal to. Pero sabi ng angel, huwag kang matakot. The Holy Spirit is within you. Ano sabi ni Mary, Mother of Jesus? Be it unto me according to your will. Amen. It means that when it comes to worship, it belongs to Him. Glory and worship belongs to God. If it belongs to Him clearly, and if we take it, we are a thief. Because worship and glory only belongs to God. Kapag kinuha natin yun, hindi sa atin yun, sa Diyos yun. Amen. Worship belongs only to God. There are people in the Bible, characters in the Bible who withheld worship from God instead of giving it to Him. kinip nila. Number one, Lucifer, the most beautiful angel in heaven. He was the worshiper. Sabi niya sa Isaiah chapter 13, verses 13 to 14, sabi dyan, "For you have said in your heart, I will ascend into heaven." Pertaining to Lucifer yan. "I will ascend into heaven. I will exalt my throne above the stars of God. I will also sit on the mount of the congregation on the farthest side of the north. I will ascend above the heights of the clouds. I will be like the Most High." That is Lucifer. I will. Five times it was mentioned. You know, anytime that I become the center of the universe, anytime that I become the center of your life, you become like Lucifer. Actually, Lucifer never planned to be the devil. Hindi niya pinlano na maging devil siya. What he did, he just withhold what belongs to God. Kinuha niya yung hindi sa kanya. Kinuha niya yung para sa Diyos. Then he become the devil. When we withhold the worship, we go from the best of us to the worst of us. Kapag po kinuha natin ang worship, ang honor and glory from God, we, from being the best, we become the worst. It is God first. It is Him first. When we withhold glory from God, it damages and destroys us. Sino pa sa Bible character? Nebuchadnezzar. Nebuchadnezzar, if you read from Daniel chapter 25, chapter 4, verses 25 to 35, Nebuchadnezzar, sobrang very successful in the history. Mababasa mo si Nebuchadnezzar yung kanyang mga accomplishments, no, yung mga hanging gardens, talagang sobrang dami ng accomplishment. And because of those accomplishments, he took the glory. Sabi niya, "Wow, ang galing, ang ganda ng mga ginawa ko dahil yan sa akin, dahil magaling ako, matalino ako." You know what the Lord said to him? "Because you took the glory, you will become like an animal in the forest." For 12 months, he lived in the forest and eat grass. He took the glory. Number three, Herod. Herod, no? When there was something miracle and amazing happened, and the people shouted, "Oh, that is the voice of God!" Sinabi ng mga tao, "Boses yan ng Diyos." Sinabi kay Herod, nung nagsalita si Herod, kinilala ng mga tao na boses daw yun ng Diyos. Hindi niya binalik sa Diyos, hindi niya sinabing, "It's not me, it's the Lord." Kinuha niya. He took the glory. And these people worshiped Herod, and he took the glory. And what happened? The worm came, and the worm ate him up. Worship is not ours to keep. It is for us to give to God. Yung story po ni Herod, makikita yan sa Acts chapter 12, verses 20 to 23. Romans chapter 1, verses 22 to 24, basahin po natin. "Claiming to be wise, they became fools and exchanged the glory of the immortal God for images resembling mortal men and birds and animals and creeping things. Therefore, God gave them up in the lust of their hearts to impurity." In other translation, "God gave them up in their passion to the dishonoring of their bodies among themselves because they exchanged the truth about God for a lie and worshiped and served the Creator rather than the Creator, who is blessed forever. Amen." When we exchange that glory, when we do not acknowledge and recognize God, instead of worshiping the Creator, instead of worshiping God, worshiping the material things, worshiping the idols. Ano sabi ni Paul? God gave them up to the lust of their hearts, to their passion. What does it mean? God gave them up to their destruction. God gave them up to their own passion. It means becoming worst version of yourself. Pag yung hinayaan ka na ni Lord, ayaw mo kalalanin ng Diyos, ayaw mo siyang sambahin, kinukuha mo yung glory, ginagawa mo yung gusto mo, your lifestyle seems you have no God. Okay, I will give up to you. I will give up in the lust of your flesh, in your own passion. But it means that you will become the worst version of yourself. These people, they knew God, but did not give Him what is due to Him. Ibigay natin ang para sa Diyos. Successful ka ngayon, ibigay mo ang pagbabalik ng pasasalamat sa Diyos. Amen. You are serving Him. That is worship. You are giving back the praise and worship to Him. Hello? E paano yung unbelievers? What about the unbelievers? They do not believe in God. So, automatic, they are not worshiping God. It does not matter. If they don't believe God, if the unbelievers doesn't believe God, their unbelief won't change the fact that worship belongs to God. Walang makakapagpabagyan. Tandaan po natin, walang makakapagpadagdag at makakapagpabawas kung sino ang Diyos. Kaya natin siya sinasamba, hindi para dagdagan yung kanyang pagka-Diyos. Siya ay Diyos na. Kaya kung hindi man siya kilalanin ng mga unbelievers, ng mga pagano, ang mga pagan po kasi, they are idol worshippers. If these people did not worship God, it doesn't matter. Because kahit anong gawin pa nila, kahit anong pang gawin ng tao, ang worship sa Diyos talaga yan. Kaya nga sa Biblia, sinabi, kung hindi kayo magpupuri, kung hindi kayo sasamba sa Diyos, kahit ang mga bato ay pagagalawin ng Diyos para magpuri at sumamba sa Kanya. Amen. Kaya nga, parang cellphone, balik tayo sa cellphone, kung sa'yo yan, kahit hindi naniniwala ang mga tao around you, no, it doesn't matter. If you have a cellphone, you own the cellphone, and the people around you doesn't believe in you, doesn't believe in your existence, it doesn't change. It doesn't change the fact that cellphone belongs to you. Amen. People don't like you, it won't change the fact that cell phone is yours. Hindi yan makaka-apekto sa ownership mo. I mean, same with God. If the people around in this world, no, doesn't recognize God, it won't affect God, His worship. Glory belongs to God. Amen. Worship belongs to God. It is not God's ego. Remember, from the very beginning, He is God. He is the Alpha and the Omega, the beginning and the end. That's why He should have no opponents. Kaya nga sinabi niya sa Ten Commandments, ayoko nang may rival. Ayoko, I am a jealous God. I don't have rival. I don't have competition. Dapat walang kakumpetensya ang Diyos sa buhay mo. Amen. Not your spouse, not your children, not your property. Hindi yan dapat kakumpetensya ng Diyos sa buhay mo. Siya ay Diyos sa buhay mo. Siya ay master sa buhay mo. At Siya ang mahal mo. Siya ang susundin mo. Amen. Lagi ko naalala po pagka kami ni Pastor Alan, kahit kung kami po ay mag-girlfriend and boyfriend pa lang at hanggang nag-asawa, lagi ako madalas sinasabi sa akin. Sabi ko, love, alam mo naman, mas mahal kita kaysa sa Diyos. Alam niyo po ba, if we love God, whatever happen, mawala ang sino man, mawala ang material man, you will still worship Him. You will still serve Him. Why? Because He is the God of your life. He is God in your life. Amen. And when you worship Him, and when you acknowledge Him as your God, no one will make you afraid. Walang makakapagpasabi sa'yo, nang tatakutin ka, sige, iwanan kita. Sisimba ka dyan, at tutuloy mo yan. Nung pagiging born again mo, pag nilingkod ka kay Lord, maglilingkod ka sa Diyos mo, walang makakapagpatakot sa'yo. Because hindi siya number one. Siya ay above everything and anyone else in your life. Amen. Hallelujah. Worship won't corrupt him. Remember, worship won't corrupt God. It won't change him because he was and he is and always. Hindi makakapagpabago sa Diyos yan. At hindi rin makakapagpataas ng ego ng Diyos ang iyong worship, ang ating worship. Wala nang makakapagpadagdag o makakapagpabawas sa kanyang pagka-Diyos. Because he is the only being. Remember this. Listen, he is the only being who is all-powerful and at the same time, all-good. What does it mean? Kapag ang tao po kasi, kinuha ang glory, no? It gets into their heads and become manipulators. Nagiging manipulators, nagiging mayabang, nagiging sinungaling, nagiging rude. You know, that's why worship is dangerous to people. We should not take worship, we should not take glory. Kasi ang Diyos, He can manage glory. He cannot be changed, He cannot be corrupted by the glory and worship that we give to Him. Hindi yung nakakapagpayabang sa Diyos. No? Hindi yung nagiging prideful si Lord na tayo ay nag-worship sa Kanya. He is still all good. He can manage. Not unlike us, kahit yung mga simpleng glory lang, simpleng appreciation, praise, hindi na natin ma-manage na yung mayabang na tayo. The word glory actually, from the original Hebrew, glory means weight. Sabihin nyo nga, weight. Bigat. No? Glory is the weight we carry. Bigat yan. No? Mabigat ang glory. Kapag kinuha mo yan, hindi mo kakayanin. Parang 1,000 watts yan na inilagay mo sa 100 watts na bumbilya sa sabog. Our spine, yung likod po natin, ay our spine is not able, no, to carry the weight of worship. Hindi natin kakayanin. Only God can manage glory. When you take worship and hold it, it will break you or destroy your back. What does it mean? When you take glory, like Lucifer, you will become prideful. And sabi ng Diyos sa James, God opposes the proud and gives grace to the humble. The moment that you take the glory, that is the moment that you will become prideful and that is the moment that you will fall. Hindi natin kayang i-take ang glory. It will mess your system. Your character will mess you. It will mess your character. But when God take worship, when God take glory, it cannot mess Him. Hindi yan makakasira sa Diyos. Hindi yan makakapagpabago sa Diyos. Hindi niya sasabihin na I am better than anybody else. Katulad ni Lucifer, he is better than I, better than you. Yet, worship was too heavy for him. Hindi kinaya ni Lucifer ang worship na kinuha niya na para sa Diyos. And it messed him up. Naging devil siya. He became evil. He became corrupt. He became prideful. He became destroyer. He became someone who gives sickness. You know, every time you give someone a worship, it will break him. It changes him. It will destroy him. It doesn't make him good. It makes him worse. We worship, we give worship to God, yet He remains good as He is. Amen. And the more we worship God, the more we glorify Him, the more we acknowledge Him, the more we adore Him, the more that He became good. The more we humble before Him and exalt His Jesus' name. The more we said, Lord, let me decrease and you increase, the more He became good to us. That's why He said, the humble, I will give grace. Amen. When worship opportunity comes in and we hold it back, yung alam yung inano ka, yung magaling mo naman, no? Wow! Ang successful mo na dyan, no? Yung pinuri ka na, grabe, yung pinag-pray mo, gumaling, ang galing mo. The moment that you hold it back, worries and fears are magnified. It makes our situation worse and permanent. Because, you know why? Nobody can maintain glory on himself. Walang kayang i-maintain ang glory. When we take it to ourselves, it would only cause more insecurities. The more we take the glory, praises to ourselves, the more that we will gonna be insecure. We will become insecure kasi kailangan mong i-maintain. And you know, we cannot maintain glory by ourselves. Glory belongs to God. And glory, kung meron nang magbibigay ng si Lord, reflection. But when you take it, the more you will gonna be insecure, it will cause you to become more envious, no? The more na magiging maingiting ka, the more that you become jealous, the more that you will become greedy, the more that you will become covetous. Kaya nga, this world, no? Kaya nga sabi ni Lord, you are in this world, but that you are not of this world. Kasi ang kompetensya dito, ang spirit ng world, yung spirit ni Lucifer, no? He encouraged the people, no? To aim high in order to get glory. Bakit may gusto di umaman, gusto maging pinakamaganda, no? Ma-influensya, gusto ng posisyon sa gobyerno. Andun lahat eh, pera, influence, tama? No, siyempre, pag mapera ka, may babae ka, maraming pupunta sa'yo. But you know, you cannot maintain that by yourselves. Ang tendency talaga ng babagsak ka pa rin. Because you cannot maintain glory by yourself. Because the more we take glory, the tendency is to become prideful and will try to maintain it. At tulad ng mga halimbawa, hindi ko naman yung talagang sobrang vain sa sarili, no? Yung glory nila is their body, their flawless skin. Eh, kung may flawless ka, talagang makinis ka, di okay naman. Pero kung nandiyan na nag-concentrate ang buhay mo, no? And you keep on, selfie, no? Talagang halos sambahin mo na ang sarili mo. Pinabago mo na lahat, mula ulo hanggang paa, pinabago na kay Belo. You know, sabi nga nila, nagiging addiction yun eh. Yung pag nagkapatangas nga namin daw, hanap ka ulit, magpapasingkit ka na ng mata, o magpapalaki ka ng mata, palalakihin mo na yung butt, yung harap mo, lahat na. It becomes an addiction, and you need to maintain it. Eh kaso, ang call of the gravity, pababa palagi, kukulbot ka pa rin. Maraming tao gusto ng glory, no? The moment you become successful, you become richer, you become famous, you become good-looking, right away, take note of this, right away, give the glory back to Him, back to God, for only God is able to manage such honor. Amen. Actually, we hold back worship for two reasons. Pride, number one, pride. It is manifested in the form of nagmamanifest yung pride. Panbas din sa word sa building natin we worship. And sinasabi mo, dapat ko worship, hindi ko favorite yung ano yung rotten, no? Ah, bago yan na, bakit yan ang kinanta? Hindi ko kabisado. Alam mo, may edad ako, dapat yung mga kahinan, no? That is pride, no? Or as they say, the song is too loud. You know, in reality, it's not about the song, it's about God. It's not about you. We are not worshiping worship. We worship God. Amen. You know, some people are in love with worship, but not with God. Many people are in love with the worship song, but not in love with God. The reason we hold back worship in our services is because sometimes, I don't know the song, I don't like the song, it's pride. Number two, problems. We hold back worship because of problems. Madalas sinasabi, hindi ako makapag-worship kay Lord, hindi ako makapag-concentrate, hindi ako makapag-church ngayon kasi may pinagdadaanan ako. Actually, we cannot afford not to worship. The more that you have problems, the more that you worship God. The more that you exalt His name. Because the only way to get out of your bad situation is worship. Naalala niyo si King Jehoshaphat, when they are about to face a war, anong ginamit nila? Sabi ng Diyos, ilagay mo ang worship team sa harap. Lahat ng mga sundalo sa likod, ang worship team nasa harap. Sa war, maglalagay mo worship team, musicians, singers. Pero yun ang inuna. Because worship will get you out of your bad situations because you exalt Him. You acknowledge Him. 2 Corinthians chapter 3 verse 18, as all of us reflect the Lord's glory with faces that are not covered with veils, we are being changed into His image with ever increasing glory. This comes from the Lord who is the Spirit. But we all with unveiled, with unveiled face, beholding as in a mirror, the glory of the Lord are transformed into the same image from glory to glory, even as from the Lord, the Spirit. Sa word, dalawang version ang binasa ko po. Beholding. Beholding. Ito po yung last point ko. Beholding the glory of the Lord. We worship Him because we become what we worship. Naalala niyo po si Moses when he went to Mount Sinai, when he climbed to Mount Sinai, dun niya for 40 days and 40 nights, prayer and fasting, nagbabad siya doon, ang kasama niya lang si Joshua nasa labas, at siya ay nanalangin. Kausap niya ang Diyos for 40 days and 40 nights. At pagbaba niya, sinulat niya yung 10 commandments, binigay sa kanya ng Panginoon. At pagkatapos pagbaba, no? Nakita niya nag-idol worship na yung mga Israelites. At nang nakita nila, nakita ni Joshua yung mukha ni Moses, nagdiningning. He reflected the glory of God. Kaya ang ginawa, tinangpan siya kasi hindi siya matitigan ng mga tao. When we behold the glory of God, it will gonna be reflected on us. We become what we worship. Kung anong sinasamba mo, yun ka. Magiging ganun ka. One of the reasons we need to worship is because whatever we worship, we become. Sabi sa Corinthians, no? Nung binasa natin, we behold. Pag sinabi mong behold, tinititigan mo, binamasdan mo, the glory, like in the mirror. Nakatawa pag kung natitingin ka sa salamin, makikita mo yung reflection mo eh. But, when we are worshiping God, we are beholding God, we are looking at His face, and nagkakaroon ng reflection going back to us. And that's why we are being transformed. Parang pag nagsalimin ka, tinititigan mo yung salamin. Marami inlove na inlove sa sarili. Sino may tumitig sa salamin? Hanggang sa oras sa ano, tumitig sa salamin ako. Oh, ay, nagpapatrag na nakakilis. Beholding their beauty. Maraming yung vain. Hindi babae, lalaki. Vain. Kaya nga nakakapagtaka sa panahon kasi namin, nung wala talagang pampabeauty product ang lalaki. Pero kahit pati lalaki, nagiging vain na. But make sure lang, no, that okay lang naman yun. Basta hindi mo sinasamba sa sarili mo. Do not behold your beauty. Behold the beauty of God. Amen? During worship, you become what you behold. Yung inahangaan mo, pinagmamasdan mo. Diba, pag may mahal na mahal ka, kahit tulog, pinamasdan mo. Ang gabugaw talaga ng asawa. Ang cute-cute talaga. Wala nang katulad. Diba? You behold. During worship, you do not behold the sickness. We do not behold the... Instead, we behold the healing. Amen? So worship, hindi natin ang tinitignan, hindi sakit ang tinitignan natin. Ang tinitignan natin yung healer. In worship, we are not beholding poverty. Hindi natin tinitignan ang kahirapan, tinitignan natin yung provider. During worship, we are not beholding the situation. We are beholding the one who is in control of everything. During worship, we are not beholding the COVID-19. We are beholding the Lord of Lords. Whatever you're beholding is your becoming. Amen. Sa mag-asawa, nakalimutan ko lang ilagay yung picture eh. Pag lagi kayo mag-long time na magkasama kayo, nagiging magkamukha kayo. Physical yan. And emotional. Spiritual. Nagiging isa at nagiging magkamukha. Sa mga pet, no? Nakalimutan ko lang ilagay yung picture eh. Nagtingin ako eh. Yung pag yung ikaw pet, tapos ikaw yung master, nagiging kamukha mo na yung pet mo. Nakita ko, pinos ko sa tulog. Pag matagal na palang inaalagaan ko si Princess Poppy, magiging kamukha ko na siya. Dapat siya ang magiging kamukha niya ako, di ba? Tama na. Magmukha sa ano, Pastor Rosara, nag-preach na rin. Ready ka ba? Ikaw, yung may asawa, ready ka bang maging kamukha mo yung asawa mo? Amen? Kaya pag pipili kayo ng asawa, yung maganda at saka okay. Hindi lang naman sa appearance siya. Kailangan din sa character. Amen? What you behold for so many years, you will become like them. What would happen if you behold the beauty and glory of God? What would happen if instead you are staring at the face of your problems, of your disappointments, staring at your haters, staring at people's opinion? You look up to the hills where your help comes from. Your help comes from the Lord. You look to the mirror of the glory of God and you become like God. God is rich, you will become rich. God is powerful, so you will stop being self-pitiful. God, and you will become powerful. God is peace, so you will be peaceful in the midst of trials. God will begin to change your life. You stop being a big victim because you behold the glory of God. Amen. You behold His compassion, you will become compassionate. You behold His love, you will become loving. You behold His forgiveness, you will become forgiving. You behold His fire, you will become passionate. Kaya nga si ang Diyos, nung nagpakita kay Moses in the form of fire, it's passion. That's why worship is very important, because during worship, you remove your eyes to where you are going through. So worship, tinatanggal natin ang mga pinagdadaanan natin, mga pangit. At ipinapako natin ang ating mata sa Diyos na lumikha sa atin at tayo ay nababago. to change yourself. You just need to change what you behold. Sino ang tinititigan mo? Sino ang pinagmamasdan mo? Sino ang sinasamba mo sa buhay mo? Change what you behold, because that is how you will gonna change who you are. You need to change, so you have to change what you absorb. Kung gusto mong magbago, maalis ang iyong addiction sa bisyo. Huwag kang magbabad dun sa inuman. Huwag kang magbabad dun sa mga bad influence. Huwag kang lagi nandun sa computer siya. Huwag kang magbabad dun sa pornographic site. Magbabad ka sa salita niya, sa worship, and you will become like Him. Amen. There are three types of worship. Idol worship. It is when we worship something or someone that is created instead of the Creator. Yun ang tinatawag na idol worship. Sinasamba mo ang tao o ang anumang bagay. Idol worship brings even spirit. Ulitin ko, idol worship brings spirit, and it is wrong. It brings bondages in your family. Tinin po yan ang idol worship sa Old Testament. Unknowingly, we worship idols. Hindi natin napapansin na worship tayo ng mga idols, because some idols are not just in the form of statue, but also in the form of material things. In the form of your car, in the form of your house, in the form of your loved ones, in the form of your job, in the form of your business, in the form of a person, and in the form of yourself. Idol worship. Number two, idol worship. Idol worship is a type of worship on lips only. Nagwo-worship ka sa muso, hindi sa puso. Jesus rebuked, na-rebuke niya mga Pharisees because they have the form of worship but they do not have the spirit of worship. May forma, mukha nagwo-worship, tumataas ang kamay, no? Pupunta sa church. Pero ang kanilang pagsamba ay hanggang sa musulo. They have the style, but they have not the substance. Worship Him. You might have the style, but you don't have the substance. You know the flow, you memorize the song, alam mo ang kanta, you sing the song, but only by your lips, but not heartfelt, and no understanding. Kumakanta ka, pero hindi mo naiintindihan kung anong kinakanta mo. At kung halino mo yan, ina-address. Katulad ng isang mama na naginip siya, at ang isang anghel, ang umihin daw pumunta, at kinuha siya, dinala siya sa church service. Tapos na, ang ganda-ganda ng settings, mas maganda siyempre dito, gaganda pa itong church natin. Pero talagang maganda, aircon, lahat ako, kumpleto ang instrument. And na-notice niya, ang mga tao doon ay kumakanta ng hymns sa mga worship song, pero during the service, wala siyang naririnig. No? Pero nakikita niya bumubukas ang bibig. Pero walang boses na lumalabas. Walang sound. Sabi niya, pag ganun, bumubuka yung bibig, kumakanta naman, sa tabi lang ako naririnig. Sabi ng anghel, no? That is how it appears in heaven. When men singing with their lips, not with their hearts, heavens hear nothing. They see the facial expression, they see the hands lifted up, but heavens are hearing nothing. Because worship is not meant just to be in our lips, or lip service, but it meant to be connected to our hearts and our spirit. And number three, ideal worship. Ideal worship. Sinabi ni Jesus, this is the ideal worship. Sinabi niya sa Samaritan woman, you worship the God that you do not know, but we Jews worship the God we know. And time will come that in this mountain, time will come that the people will gonna worship God in spirit and in truth. That's why we do not worship Him just in the church, in the temple. We worship Him in spirit and in truth. Kahit nasa bahay ka, nasa jeep ka, nasa kalsada ka, you worship Him. Because we worship Him in spirit and in truth. We are connected. God. We are alive in spirit. We are born of the spirit. Kaya kahit saan tayo, worship natin si Lord. Yung life na natin, yung buhay na natin, yung pagmamahal natin sa kapwa natin ay worship. Yung paggalang natin sa magulang natin ay worship. Yung pagtulong natin sa mga nangangailangan ay worship. Yung pagtangki natin sa mga bisyo ay worship. Your heart must be connected with your lips. Meaning, in spirit, the Holy Spirit is helping us to where your spirit is connected to the Spirit of God. You know, a spirit is not born again. A person is not born again. Not born of the Spirit, sinabi sa John 3:3, cannot worship God. They cannot worship God. Kaya pag hindi born again, hindi pwedeng sumamba. Kaya maraming religion, maraming cult, nag-offer pa sila ng pagkain, diba? Pinapaligoon pa ng gatas. It's not worship. You can only worship God if you are born of the Spirit, if you are born again, if you experience the John 3:3. Meaning, your spirit is alive to connect, communicate with God. A religious people, God, they worship God when they carry the idols, when they parade the idols, when they attend the mass, the services. Worshiping God in spirit has something to do with your spirit, which is alive in Christ. Only in Christ. Fulfilling religious activity is not worship. Kaya nga, pag sinabi mo, pumunta ka sa akin, simba ko dito. It's not sure talaga na talagang nagsambayan, sumumbayan. At tulad ni David, there are some many forms of worship na ginagawa ng tao. Si David nag-faith din. Alam niyo ba nag-faith din si David sa worship? Kasi yung Ark of the Covenant, hindi niya pinano yung instruction ng Diyos. Nilagay niya sa cart, sa oxen. Hinila ng oxen ang cart at nandun ang Ark of the Covenant. Hindi yun ang instruction ng Diyos para dalhin ang presence ng Lord, ang Ark of the Covenant. Dapat kakargahin ng apat na priest on their shoulder. But what happened? Alam niyo nangyari? Kapag hindi talaga tayo nag-obey, kahit si David pa yan, hindi niya in-obey ang instruction. Nung natumba yung Ark of the Covenant, sinalo ni Uza. Patay si Uza. Right away. Umiyak si David. Sabi niya, Lord, paano ba ako i-carry ang Ark of the Covenant? Binalikan niya, paano ba i-carry ang Ark of the Covenant? You know yung Ark? Ark is a form of religion. Trying hard to carry His presence through our wrong sacrifices, through religion. To worship Him in spirit requires a genuine relationship with God, and that is through obedience. And in truth, acceptable worship to God is not based on emotion. We worship Him in truth. Because we worship Him not basing on our emotion, not our feelings, but on truth. True is different from truth. True is a fact, while truth is the principle. Yung truth, yung facts, pwede magbago. Yes, may COVID-19 tayo. True yan. Fact yan. But the truth is, God is our healer, God is our protector. That is the principle. We worship Him not by the based on the fact, but based on the principle who God is. Amen? Jesus said, I am the way, the truth, and the life. We worship Him not because we feel good. We worship Him not because we are overwhelmed. We worship Him not because we are blessed. We worship Him not because we feel happy. We worship Him according to His word. What the scripture says about Him, regardless of what you feel right now, you still worship Him. Masama ang pakiramdam mo, you don't feel good, nalulungkot ka, masaya ka, galit ka, whatever your feelings right now, you worship Him because you worship Him not according to what you feel, but according to the Bible, to the scripture, what the Bible tells about God. He is God and He deserves our worship. Amen. the Lord, even when you feel you're losing. His word tells us that He is our healer, even when we feel sick. His word tells us that He is our provider, even when we feel empty. His word tells us that He is in control, even when we feel that chaos is all around. His word tells us that He loves us, even when we feel unloved. His word tells us that He forgives us, even we feel that we are guilty. That's why we worship Him. To enlighten us more about worship in spirit and in truth, let us take a look in Genesis 22 verse 9. I'm sorry, medyo mag-exan lang ng konti. Sabi ni Abraham, dun sa kanyang mga servant, "The boy and I will go little farther. We will worship there and we will come right back." Dinala niya kasi yun na yung i-offer niya si Isaac. Tapos sabi niya sa mga servants, "Diyan lang kayo, huwag na kayo sumama. Pupunta kami little farther. Mag-worship kami. At babalik kami." Itong word na worship, first time dito binanggit sa Genesis. Sabi niya, "We will worship. We will come back." It implies that we will come back together. Alam ni Abraham na si Isaac will gonna die because he will be an offering, even though willing siya mag-offer, no? Willing siya i-offer si Isaac, pero ang faith niya, babalik kami. Hallelujah! Amen! Mag-worship kami. Abraham said, "We will go and worship." Kasi ang definition ng worship natin requires instruments, no? Requires musicians. Requires song. Requires congregation. But in Genesis chapter 2, 22 verse 5, sabi ni Abraham, "We will worship." Wala naman tayo nakita worship din doon sa bundok. Walang instrument, walang musician, walang kanta, walang music except an altar and an offering. Sacrifice. And Abraham said, "We will go up and worship." Ang first definition of worship in the Bible has nothing to do with songs, nothing to do with singing, nothing to do with the posture, nothing to do with the style and form of worship. It has to do with the spirit of worship, which is obedience. Bakit nandun si Abraham? Kasi sinabi ng Diyos sa kanya, "I-offer mo si Isaac sa amin." And Abraham obeyed. Amen. Abraham comes to God and offers to Him his son Isaac. God requires Abraham to offer his son out of obedience, which God actually do 2,000 years ago. Sabi niya, "I-offer mo yung anak mo." Pero hindi, di ba hindi naman tutuloy, nag-provide siya ng ram. And that ram signifies, symbolizes Jesus. He sent His Son 2,000 years ago to be the offering for the redemption of all. God was not after Isaac. God was not after your offering. God did not want to remove Isaac out of the life of Abraham. Makinig po kayo. God was not after Isaac. God did not want to remove Isaac from Abraham's life. God wanted to remove Isaac from his heart. Amen. Gusto lang siguro dalhin ng Diyos na yung nakaupo dyan sa puso mo, hindi yung anak mo, ako. That's why He required Abraham to offer his Isaac. And the whole hero of this story is not Abraham, it is God. Amen? And if you wanted to approach God in worship, you have to offer the sacrifice that God gave you. Amen? Not your sacrifice. May binigay na sa'yo si Lord. Yun ang i-offer mo. But go those sacrifices sometimes we withdraw. Amen. Yun ang pinapaupo natin sa puso natin. Isaac will be a sacrifice that will cost Abraham everything, but to God, Isaac cost nothing. Amen. Hallelujah. Worship is when you come to God and offer to Him. Come to Him through Jesus Christ. He is the utmost offering and sacrifice. Worship is coming to Him not through religious activities, not just by sitting and listening to the message, but it is your obedience. Through Christ Jesus, who is the truth, and only Jesus, only through Jesus, you can approach God in worship. And make sure, ngayong umaga, that Jesus is sitting on your heart, on the throne of your heart. You receive Him as Lord and Savior. Because you cannot worship God without Jesus. When we have only Jesus in our lives, we have everything. In Jesus, we have healing. We have deliverance, we have freedom, we have victory, we have provision. Through Jesus, we not only have the salvation, but also the blessings in our lives. Jesus is the only ticket to heaven. Jesus is the only way going through the throne of God. Amen. So we worship Him for who He is, for He is to us. For what He is to us, and we worship Him to become like Him. To become like Him is not by eating from the tree of good of knowledge or from the tree of knowledge of good and evil. We will become God not by listening to the devil's voice, not by listening to the voice, opinions of this world. We will become like Him when we worship Him. His glory we behold, and His reflection will transform us. Amen. Let us all stand up. Hallelujah! Hallelujah! We glorify Your name, God. Yes, we are grateful, Lord, that You are our God. You deserve the glory. You deserve our lives. You deserve our offering our lives as a sacrifice and offering. Romans chapter 12. Offer yourself unto Jesus, unto Him. The living sacrifice, it's your life. You behold His glory. You behold your God in worship. You behold your God in a lifestyle of worship. You behold your God through Jesus. You behold your God by your obedience. Hallelujah. Let's sing this song, I Will Glorify the Lord. Yes, our worship is not just confined in this room. Our worship is wherever we go. Wherever we go, we worship Him. Amen. And He deserves all the glory, praises, and honor. And even your life, nag-withhold ka ng glory, ng praise sa sarili mo. It's about time, every minute, every second of your life, every success, every wealth, every influence, everything that you achieve, you give it back to God. Amen? Hallelujah. Praise your name, Lord. Hallelujah. Come on, let's worship Him. Worship Him. Give God what is due to Him. Everything. Hallelujah. Yes, Lord. Yes, Lord. Be magnified. Be glorified. Hallelujah. Yes, Jesus. You can close your eyes and let your heart focus on Him. Hallelujah. Lord, patawarin mo po kami if anything that we take, Lord, and withheld sa amin, Panginoon. Forgive us. Hallelujah. Cleanse us and wash us with the precious blood of Jesus. Hallelujah.
My God, I worship, and I
sabihin, ang pagsunod mo. Ang pagsunod mo. Katulad ni Abraham, sinampa niya ang Diyos sa pamamagitan ng kanyang pagsunod. Maraming dinidilat niya na require sa atin ng Lord, pero hindi natin pinapansin. Ang Diyos ay mangungusap sa iyo sa pamamagitan ng Biblia, sa pamamagitan ng iyong mga pastor, or maaaring sa iyong devotion. What God requires is your obedient heart. That's nothing to do with the offering that God is requiring you, but He wanted to make sure that your heart belongs to Him. Hallelujah. Amen. Tayo po'y manalangin. Papanalangin ko po lahat ng nais makaranas ng John 3:3. Born of the Spirit. If you do not confess Jesus, if you do not yet confess Jesus as your Lord and Savior, you're not still born again. You cannot worship God in spirit and in truth. Unang hakbang, tanggapin mo si Jesus bilang Panginoon na tagapagligtas. Manalangin tayo. Panginoong Diyos, salamat po sa pagmamahal at pagbigay ng iyong utong na anak na si Jesus. Patawarin mo po ako na pakarami ko pong nagawang kasalanan. Inisip mo po ako ng dugo ni Jesus. At sa oras na ito, naniniwala po ako at tinatanggap po si Jesus bilang Panginoon na tagapagligtas. At ipinapahayag ko sa sa aking mga labi at sa aking puso na si Jesus ay tagapagligtas at Panginoon. Maraming salamat po at sinabi mo sa iyong salita ang sino mong nakipag-isa sa iyo ay ituturing mo anak mo. Salamat po, salamat Panginoon. At sa oras na ito, pagpalain mo po ang aming mga kapatid, ang mga leaders, ang mga disciples, ang bawat isa sa amin na narito, Panginoon, ang buhay po namin ay isang tunay na pagsamba sa loob at labas ng building na ito, ng sanctuary na ito. Dahil kahit saan, sinabi mo, we can worship you in spirit and in truth. Lord, salamat po. Marapat dapat ka, Panginoon. Marapat dapat ka, Panginoon, mamalhatiin at papurihan. Hallelujah! Hallelujah! Yes, Lord! Glorify your name, Lord. We thank you, Jesus! Praise, praise, praise! Hallelujah! Hallelujah! I will glorify the Lord. Glorify.
kunin ang kunanan